Huzzah!
I thought we were doing a medieval sketch, no? Sci-fi? So, we've been on our journey so far. We've planned an essay, we've written the introduction. The last thing to do is to write our conclusion. And if my intellect serves me correctly, I can call out of the ether the first thing that you need to remember, which is to show your line of argument, to make sure that your argument has been consistent and make sure that it comes out in your final paragraph, which is your conclusion in your essay. Let's have a look then at what showing your line of argument actually entails in your conclusion. I've got here a conclusion that I've written earlier. You can pause the video if you want to read through the whole thing. I'm not going to read it out to you now because it would take too much time. But what I will do is highlight for you the places where I have showed my line of argument. So you can see there in the bold and underlined places at the beginning of the paragraph and at the end, an ideal place to show the reader what your conclusion and what your whole essay is all about. So in this case, it's about the fact that the ideological differences between the superpowers were consistently the main cause of tension between them from 1945 to 49. So I'm referring directly to the question, I'm using the words of that question, and in so doing, I'm showing my line of argument. Our next one is to make sure that you are evaluating your factors. You are making links between them, but you're also balancing up the different sides of the argument and showing those in the debate. So what does evaluate mean? Well, here's the definition for it from the dictionary or from Google, for those technologically inclined. To form an idea of the amount, number, value of something, or simply to assess. If you are showing that you have come to a conclusion in your essay, you're going to need to show that you've assessed the different sides of the historical debate. And as I said previously in other videos, more often than not, an historical debate will have more than two sides to it. It's not just one or the other, yes or no. It's often more nuanced than that. So you're going to have to try and relate that in your conclusion. So how have I done it in this Cold War essay question? Well, if you've read through the whole conclusion, you might have seen where I've done it already. But here it is, highlighted for you in red. The USSR's expansion in Eastern Europe was not wholly ideological and was often carried out by means of political and military influence in the region. However, the USA's reaction to this expansion, culminating in the Truman Doctrine, appeared to view communism as an ideological threat that had to be contained. So what I've done there is I've taken a couple of factors, the USSR's expansion in Eastern Europe, paired it up with ideology and said that it wasn't wholly ideological, and also link that to the USA's reaction to the USSR's expansionism. I've talked about the Truman Doctrine, so I've referred back to some of the evidence that I've mentioned in my essay. What I haven't done is go into a lot of detail of that evidence here, because I probably would have done that in the essay, hopefully. And don't forget, this is the conclusion. You don't want it to be too long. But what I've shown how those factors pair up, link together, so that we can see that there's been some evaluation that's taken place between them. And at the end, I've worded this using some language which helps to show the reader that I understand what I'm talking about by saying that difference in ideology remained embedded in the USA's reaction. So that says it was always there in the USA's reaction to the expansion of the communists, and this was the underlying cause of tension. Look at that tasty word there, underlying. It means it was always present under the surface, like a wily shark swimming underneath your argument. So there's some evaluation. The third thing is to make sure that you link between factors, you make comparisons between them. Comparisons are good because they show that you are evaluating. They're part and parcel of that evaluation. Up next, we're going to look at comparison and linking between factors. Well, I've alluded to this thing already, but to make it even clearer for you, in the red is my evaluation. Highlighted are the places where I've linked factors together. Now, this comes part and parcel
with your evaluation, really. If you aren't linking things together, if you aren't making comparisons between things, then you're not evaluating. So you must make sure that you're making some connections between paragraphs in your essay, or between the factors that you've considered. So there's one in yellow there, and there's one in blue. The first one is linking the USA's reaction to communist expansion to the ideological threat of communism, and the second one in blue is talking about the USA's response to Soviet expansion being a financial one, but one that was nevertheless strongly tied, I've put here, to communist ideology.
And the last thing, I can't quite remember it.
Use the force.
I can't quite remember it. What is it? Use.
Let go.
Use the words of the question.
Last but not least, I've mentioned this before and I'll mention it again. I'll say it in nearly every video because it's really, really important. Because if you don't use the words of the question, you can't answer the question. So, in all of this maelstrom of underlining and highlighting in different colours, where have I used the words of the question? Well, the beginning of the conclusion is a good place to do that because it signposts to the reader that you're drawing your essay to a conclusion now. Here I've used the word ideology, well, in the form of ideological. I've used the word difference. I've used the word tension, the main cause of tension between the two superpowers. So I think that's enough words of the question there to show the reader that I am answering the question that has been set, and I'm not just telling a story or just waffling. Also at the end, I've come back to this question of ideology, and I've shown you where I've done that there by starting off that last sentence by talking about difference in ideology. It's a good idea to do that because it shows again to the reader that you're linking your argument consistently, always, back to the question. So then, let's have a recap before we finish with all this. How should you write a conclusion? Well, number one, make sure that you show your line of argument. Number two, evaluate your different factors, and you're going to do that by making links and comparisons between those factors. I should also add into this contrast as well. You might show how one factor differs from another one, particularly if you're talking about the levels of change that have taken place, if your essay is about change and continuity. And last but not least, whatever essay you are writing, make sure that you use the words of the question. So to finish this video off, we should talk a bit about the piece that we've been listening to, which is of course Mars from the Planet Suite by the English composer Gustav Holst. Now this piece was composed at the beginning of the First World War, and I've got a bit of a chronologically bad photo there because that's from the end of the First World War because there's a tank in the picture. But Mars was composed at the same time as the First World War was breaking out. Not to say that it was connected to the First World War in any way, because Gustav Holst based it on the astrological significance of the planet, but from how the piece goes and the machine-like qualities in it, such as the strings starting off with using the wood of their bow instead of the horsehair, it sounds very much like the industrialization of warfare. And of course, it's become incredibly influential for science fiction films in general. One composer, namely John Williams, the master of the orchestral score for movies in our recent times, took a lot of inspiration from Gustav Holst's music, and in particular for Star Wars from the Planet Suite.
I've just got to test to see if this works. That's it for me. See you again next time on Mr. Keet in the Classroom.